Good afternoon. As promised, we want to update everyone on the results of today's Render and Safe operation, which called for a controlled detonation of explosive materials discovered at an apartment complex located at 109 Canop Drive here in Beaver Dam. I'm joined once again this afternoon by Dodge County Sheriff Dale Smith, FBI Special Agent in Charge Justin Tolmail, Fire Chief Alan Mano, and the Mayor, City of Beaver Dam, Becky Gluin. The controlled detonation of the highly explosive materials took place at 1:31 p.m. today. The operation was a success, eliminating the threatening explosive material. All people and pets were evacuated. The body in the affected unit was removed last night. A large vent was cut in the roof and sandbags strategically placed in and around the apartment to direct the expected shock wave and minimize the impact. Doors, windows, and patio doors at adjoining properties were boarded with plywood to mitigate the effects of any shock wave. Vehicles were towed to prevent damage. Charges were placed in and around the affected apartment. After the detonation, there was a fire in the attic area and adjacent apartments, extinguished by the Beaver Dam Fire Department. There was some structural damage to the building and pending review by a structural engineer. As a result of all these mitigating factors, the damage from the explosion was less severe than anticipated by the experts. At this point in time, we are anticipating some evacuated residents of nearby locations to begin moving back in tonight or tomorrow. We will be discussing the facilitation of re-entering those properties in private with the residents at another town hall meeting this evening at 5 o'clock p.m. That meeting will be back in the basement of St. Catherine Drexel Parish Center. That is located at 408 South Spring Street with the FBI Victim Assistance Specialist, Dodge County Emergency Management, and Dodge County Sheriff Dale Schmidt. For any residents that were directly affected by the incident. Again, the town hall is for residents only and not open to the general public or the media. I want to thank all the partners in this effort and all the agencies that assisted in the operation, to include the Dodge County Sheriff's Office, Emergency Management, the FBI, ATF, Wisconsin DCI, Dane County Sheriff's Office, Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office, and a long list of other law enforcement agencies and fire rescue agencies in responding to this incident. Thank you very much, and at this time, we'll take a few questions.
Chief, now that you neutralized...
Okay, go ahead. We'll start up here. Go ahead.
Thank you. So what can you tell us about the guy who had these explosives? Have you had any interaction with him in the past? Does he have a criminal record?
Again, Justin Tolmail right now, the subject and the resident has not been positively identified. So at the time that we do have a positive identification, we can speak more to that. But right now, until we have such, we're going to withhold any information concerning him.
And I know one concern is that we got that email from the sheriff about a week and a half ago about the outlaws being in the area. We know that they have a history with bombs and explosives. Is there any connection there?
There's no clear connectivity to that group at this point.
You know, neutralizing those explosives, how does that enhance the investigation at this point?
The explosives were rendered safe in order for the residents and some normalcy to return to the community. Information and evidence was obtained prior to the detonation, and we're assessing that currently.
And you previously had said it was too dangerous to remove the body. How was that obstacle overcome?
Through the specialist in their review, they were able to remove that body carefully and then proceed towards the remediation.
I know it's very early in the investigation, but any idea why someone would have so many volatile chemicals because they're doing like this?
That's the question. That's a good question. And currently, in collaboration with the law enforcement agencies, we're looking into that right now, and we hope to have answers.
If you live nearby, should you be concerned at all by the fumes from anything or any secondary?
There's no assessment of any contaminants or any other hazardous material in the area, and that's why now we're having discussions about letting residents come back to their homes.
Thank you.
Was evidence removed beforehand, or because of this controlled explosion, was any of that evidence going to be destroyed as a result of it, you know, kind of piecing this together?
We removed pertinent evidence at the time.
Was there any journals or any documents found within that apartment that would give you any indication of why this person had this many explosives?
Right now, any information that was pertinent was removed, and we're assessing it. There were improvised explosive material with a variety of precursor chemicals that gave us great pause and were highly volatile, and henceforth the need to render safe in place and not move those materials, because that was a very grave risk to officer safety.
Do you think anyone else could be connected to this? Is there anyone else you're looking for?
Currently we're assessing that.
Special agent, could these materials be acquired over the internet or at retail locations? Are they that accessible?
Unfortunately, you can make explosives in a variety of different manners with household chemicals. I can't speak directly to that situation, but yes, that is the case in a number of incidents, and we're seeing what those materials were and how they were obtained.
Can you tell if the explosion, the initial one, was accidental or purposeful?
I'm assuming right now that it was accidental, given the subject and the residence was killed as a result.
And I know you said the damage wasn't as bad as it could have been with this, what you did today, but how bad are the apartments damaged? Do we know how many or anything like that?
Well, I'll speak to the remediation part. The bomb technicians and specialists did a yeoman's effort in terms of trying to secure and harden areas around the detonation area. And insofar as we could protect those surrounding residences, that was certainly a success. Clearly, we knew that there would be some damage to the unit itself and maybe some of the surrounding and adjacent apartments, which did occur. However, given the volatility of the materials, they were successful in detonating those materials and didn't have any secondary explosions. So we consider that a good achievement and a good outcome.
And I have Chief, if you want to speak for. Okay.
Is there any other question? We'll take just a couple more questions. That's it.
Chief,
just one or two more questions.
For you to respond to that apartment in the past, say in this year or the previous year, did you have any calls for service to that apartment?
That's what we're investigating right now.
Have any potential family members or friends or anyone connected to this guy?
That's what we're investigating right now. It's too early in the investigation. So I want to thank you all for coming. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.